Hi everyone. We again have a great announcement to make. JCB has again been expanded to now include a language translation feature. We are very grateful. One of our contributors have extended the code base for this. We obviously working together to ensure that it remains stable. Those of you that have been following the process on GitHub will know that there's much time and effort been put into this. So I would like to give you a quick explanation of how this will work. Those of you that are already using JCB or ACB, it depends on who you're asking, ACB Advanced Component Builder or JCB Joomla Component Builder, it is actually an English component, and it builds the English language file for you. So everywhere in your fields, when you create a field, there are areas in the field that says that it's translatable, not translatable, translatable, and if you enter those values here, JCB on the fly would take this description, for example, and it will convert it into a language placeholder and it'll add it to the language file, the English language file, the British one. Now, this is all being done automatically for every area of the JCB compiler. Even in templates and in views, that's now your front end. If you create site views and even templates and layouts, you can just adding these placeholders, these JText with the actual English language string in it, then the parser would automatically grab that text and add it to the language file. So currently JCB is building a complete English language file for you. And that means it's already able to be, translated. But it has not had the feature for you to add multiple other languages. And so that is really what has been the request. The request is, isn't there a way we could actually translate these language strings? And then when JCB compiles the component, it'll automatically add these other languages. And so the suggestion was that we basically add an area where you can create as many languages as you like, obviously in accordance with the conventions. Your language tags need to be in accordance with the correct prefixes used in Joomla. So I think we could add a link here, maybe on this page at some point, just to take you somewhere where you can find all the information to use the correct tagging for your language file. And here you could obviously add the language name, and so you can create as many languages as you like. Then when you compile a component, JCB obviously, like I've explained, grabs all the strings from everywhere and adds them to the British English translation file. Now let me show you some of that happening in the code. So here in the get class, we have a function called setLangStrings. It gets the content from wherever JCB is handing it, and it parses it to see whether it has either this language string or that one. Then it does some gymnastics here to grab all the actual strings into an array. And then it parses this array once it has it, and it converts it to a language string, and it adds it back into the content and returns the content. And then with this we call it an object array, it is adding the language string and the language key to the lang content array. So that's the first thing. We have this lang content array that's all over the place, and it just gets bulkier and bulkier, Now this lang is basically the target. It's the area which this language strings belong to, either the site or the site system or the admin or the admin system area. So there are four areas where the site, this language string, or there is also such a thing as both. While JCP compiles, some strings he knows must go to both. And this is the actual language string, the capitalized string, which is generated up here. And this is then trimmed and placed in its place. Now, this array gets placed into the files at a certain point. That point is very much at the very end of the compilation, of course, when everything has been sort of done. We actually get to the place where we're going to now add the strings to the files. So first we are basically calling a function called setLangAdmin, setLangSystem. Basically, this is in the interpreter. You can see these methods are here, the setLangSite. Here is setLangAdmin. Basically adds a bunch of strings that are default always being added. And then also all the other strings that have been built. And it then moves them over to a string called language, and obviously the British English, and it's for the admin area. And so it does for all the various areas. And this in the infusion class, it brings it together. And then we grab the values of this strings, we add it to our value array, and we basically have the whole multi-language implementation running down from here, from line 197. We start running into the multi-language string implementation. Now what does this do? Basically, it queries the database to see whether there is such a English language string in the database and whether there has been any translations made for it. So it doesn't really use the placeholders, because the placeholders are so ambiguous between various components, and our idea was to prevent a very bloated, oversized database. We must try to share strings amongst components. And so currently when you compile a component, it gathers its English strings, like I've explained, and then it checks the database whether these English strings already exist in the database. And if they do, it then checks whether they have translations already linked to them. And if they do, then it starts grabbing that translation strings and adds them to this language object array, also by tag and by area. And then here we are basically parsing this array. So by this time we already have all the languages in place, and we are now able to put them into the component. So it's basically these functions: get multiple strings, multi-language strings, set lang placeholders, purge lang strings. These are the functions that actually does the work. So you could go look at these. They are all found in the get class, the one where everything really starts. They are found there, and you can look at them. They are all their doings are obviously open source, so you could see. Now, so that means by the point we get to this line 1109, we already have all the language strings in their various areas and various languages. And we can now start adding them back into the component. And that's really what this part is doing. It's just adding it into the component. So, now let's go back to the user interface to see this in action. So I'm going to compile a component, just any component, let's say this document manager. And while I'm compiling it, so keep in mind, it will be running through and grabbing all the English strings, then eventually it will check this language translation table whether those strings actually exist, and if they do, if they've been translated. Okay, so that's basically as simple as that. It compiles it, and it does most of the work for you. Now, the question has been asked, what if you've changed some field's name or some description, and now that other description, that old English string, is no longer being used? What then? Well, at the moment, it will basically be purged. Now, the purging works as follow. When it discovers that a string is no longer being used by a component, we can go in the code and I can show you that. Then it basically asks the question, is another component still using it? Okay, check if more components are using it. And if another component is using it, it simply removes the current component from the string, and then it goes on. It doesn't remove it. If no other component is using it, so let's say no other component is any longer linked to the string, then it checks whether there has been any work done in it. Has there been translation done? I mean, it's quite a huge job to do translation. So we figured if you've done it, you wouldn't want to just delete it. So what we'll do then is we basically archive the string. We move it from the published state to an archived state, so you can go to archives and then there see all the strings that no longer are actively linked to a component but has translations in it. And if it does not have any translation, so you've seen it's not linked to a component and it does not have translation, then we remove the string from the database. So these are the two functions to remove the string completely. And so it's like it never was there in the first place. And so that is really how the purge works at the moment. It only purges that which really is no longer linked, neither has any work done in it. And so that is what's happening at the moment. Okay, so now if we were to go to this component in JCB, so the document manager, you'll see there's a new tab called translation. And in this tab, it shows you all the English strings, whether it's been having any work done in it. So it will say no translation when no work has been done to it. And in how many components it's being used. So currently, most of these strings, as you see, are used in quite a few other components. And now you can, from here, click on any of these strings and it will give you the list of all the components where it's used. It will show you the string. You cannot edit the string here, but you can add translations. So here you'll select the language and you'll add the translation, and you can add as many as you like to the string, and then in every one of these components this translation will be active. So that is really how the translation manager works. There are two ways to get to these strings. The one is, like I've shown you, via the component. And we are planning to add a button here whereby you can import these and export these strings quite easily, so that you could give them to other team members who can then make translations, give them back to you, and you just import them here and then it gets linked automatically. So that is still under development. It should come out soon, within the next, well, let me not give any promises, as soon as we have the time. And so to make it easier to do these translations. The other way to get to these translations is to simply go to language translations, and here you'll find all the component strings together. So this could become a database with over 8,000 lines, I suppose. But like you see, it's working quite well. I've already got a lot of components mapped. The ones that you see usually are only the ones that are active, which I'm working on. I have quite a few in archive as well. So the reality is, I've been testing this against, you know, say 8-9 components at the same time, sharing strings among each other. And I expect this feature to become quite powerful as soon as we are able to, you know, speed up the translation method. There has been suggestions that we also add this feature to a sort of a community area somewhere where you can push your English strings there, and you can pull already translated strings from it. I know this is a great idea, but how to manage that so that we don't find people abusing the system, still under debate. So anyone have any good suggestions, please go to GitHub, open an issue, and let's start talking. Well, I hope this is enough explanation on how to do multiple language implementation on your components in Joomla Component Builder. I'm quite happy about this new feature. I really think it will, in the long run, become a very valuable asset. Anyway, thank you very much for watching. Goodbye.